Hey everybody, how's it going? Icy Cat here. Today we've got some exciting new information. We're going to be getting the first look at the two new operators that are going to be coming to us next season in Operation Chimera. We'll also get an early look at what their weapons and abilities might be, as well as talk a little bit more information about Outbreak. Today Ubisoft posted this on the official dev blog, the link to which you'll find in the comments below the video player. This is the Year 3 Season 1 kickoff and sneak peek for Operation Chimera and Outbreak. It reads, "Welcome to Year 3 of Rainbow Six Siege. Your continued support allows us to create new content, and we're thrilled to reveal what's under the command tent. Push the flap aside and come on in. We're starting the year with Operation Chimera and a new, specialized CTU in the lineup. Biological and chemical attacks are growing threats to operators. Six created the Chemical, Biological, Radiological, Nuclear Threat Unit. CBRN is its own distinct CTU. This means that it's not coming from any specific existing CTU. This is one that was specifically designed as part of Team Rainbow." It goes on to say, "The following two experts know what they're doing and they'll never turn their backs on a hot zone. These two new operators are joining the multiplayer roster and will also be playable in the limited time Outbreak event along with other legacy operators. This means any question of specialized operators that are only playable in the Outbreak mode are now out. You can play any of the operators in the Outbreak mode, including these two new ones that will be available in both multiplayer and Outbreak. One operator hails from France and uses a drone to maintain quarantine perimeters. Their service record is astounding, but their list of regrets seems endless. The other operator moved to Russia to pursue their studies, and they uncovered a range of applications for self-dissolving nanobots. All allies can benefit from the research carried out by this CBRN specialist." It then goes on to expand on Outbreak itself. "Suit up and check your gear, because Rainbow Six is tackling an epidemic consuming the town of Truth or Consequences, New Mexico. Choose your best team of three to neutralize the threat. If you don't choose your operator in time on the operator selection screen, your man recruit will still have your back as always. He's ready to serve. This limited time co-op event is free for everyone who has a copy of Rainbow Six Siege. To learn more about Outbreak, check in regularly on the Rainbow Six website. This event also offers exclusive headgear, uniforms, weapon skins, and charms to customize Rainbow Six operators." Then it tells you for more information on the Outbreak collection to check out the blog post. And we did talk about that in the video that we were doing last week about how we now have these new RNG loot crates, which means that you can't necessarily buy the specific items that you want to get. You can spend 300 rainbow credits. There is no renown purchase option, and you have to basically gamble on what you may or may not be getting. There's up to 50 items that are available in that collection, and these are Operation Outbreak packs. They're similar to the Alpha packs, but they're specific for that mode. They work a little differently, and if you want more information on the way that those function, then take a look at the video that I did on that covering that topic last week. We did also go over a first look at what the new zombie creatures are probably going to be looking like based on the concept art that was revealed at that time. So let's go back and take a look at this main image here. We can tell a few very interesting things. The first thing is we see our two new operators. This is what they're going to look like. So we have this guy in front, and you can see, if you zoom in and take a look on his shoulder there, that is the French flag. Both of these operators do appear to be wearing some kind of hazmat suit, and this guy looks like he's probably a thicker build, heavier armor. He's holding what looks to be a Vector 45 ACP SMG. This would be the same one that Mira has. Notice, however, that there's a drum mag attached to the bottom of that magazine well. Some people have speculated that this might actually be an AA-12 shotgun. That's an automatic shotgun that's typically drum-fed, although it can come with a standard magazine as well. But if you take a look at the profile of the body of this weapon, it does not match the AA-12. The drum magazine on that sits up right underneath the body of the weapon itself. You can see that this sits at the bottom of the extended magazine chamber that we have on the Vector 45. That long length feed chamber accommodates the double stack 45 ACP magazine. Furthermore, if you take a look at the front of the weapon there, just above where the barrel protrudes out, you can see that that's chopped completely flat, exactly like the 45 ACP Vector is. You can also see the back stock of the weapon, and the positioning of the hand in particular is very important to tell you the configuration of this weapon does match the Vector, not the AA-12. So this is interesting because it's a gun that is already in the game. However, we have a variation of it. That extended magazine will probably be a default part of the weapon, much like Jackal's SMG has its drum magazine as its standard option as well. We'll have to see what other ways they'll make this have a variation to it from the way it handles versus Mira's SMG. Taking a look at the operator in back, this looks to be a woman, a lighter build, so probably a three-speed operator. It's a little less clear what's in her hand for the weapon. It does appear to be some kind of an assault rifle, and a lot of people are thinking that what we may be looking at here is actually the Aserich 308, or some kind of variation thereof. I'm not 100% ready to go with that yet. I can't see as much of this weapon as I can of the Vector, but it does seem a likely candidate, making this some kind of a heavier caliber gun. Now let's go back and talk about the operator abilities that were mentioned. So on the onset, it's not real obvious what these necessarily do. It's really, really vague. For instance, the first one, the French operator uses a drone to maintain quarantine perimeters. What does that mean? That could mean literally anything. But we have a frame of reference. Do you remember this image? This was back from before Operation White Noise even launched, before we even got teaser trailers for most of the content that was there. And it talked about how we had this new Aliens and Zombies mode, and a lot of people wrote it off as just, you know, not being accurate. But if you go back and look at it, it predicted the name of the operation, the name of Zofia, what her ability was, what Vigil's ability was. It talked about pretty much everything accurately. You know, we even got information on what Dokubi was, and then it talked about this Aliens and Zombie mode. And some people were really interested in this because there were going to be some new Mexican operators coming. And then this turned out to maybe not be the case because it was revealed that the new operators were going to be from France and Russia, respectively. However, let's take a look back at that sentence, and it is actually accurate. It was just misunderstood. People thought that meant new Mexican operators, but actually it was just referring to New Mexican operators, as in Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, and the game mode that would come with it. At the time the 4chan leak was originally posted, keep in mind this was already a few months back, they may not have had all the information on exactly where these operators were going to be coming from that we wound up learning in the Year 3 roadmap. This was probably, at the time, the only way they knew how to reference them because they knew that the map would be taking place in New Mexico. And it says here that the operators have a hazmat suit kind of look to fit with the theme of zombies. That does match up with the Operation Chimera artwork that we are now seeing. It says the first operator has two charges, a temporary heal of 40, recoil reduction, and a speed buff, and the second operator has a one-use pulse for wall hacks, duration of 10 seconds, doesn't update in real time, pulses every 2 seconds. It then says they're probably going to be nerfed before release, though. So taking a look at this, I think that maybe that second operator is actually referencing the French operator's drone. The drone may have the ability to send out this pulse wall hack kind of a thing. Now, we do know that the French operator is the one shown holding a submachine gun, so that might mean that we may be seeing a Defender with a drone kind of along the lines of Echo. And again, this is somewhat speculation here as far as to what that drone's ability would be, but everything in that 4chan leak did pan out to be accurate information. Now let's go back and take a look at the other operator ability. It says that the Russian operator pursued their studies and uncovered a range of applications for self-dissolving nanobots. All allies can benefit from the research carried out by this CBRN specialist. Let's reference back to that 4chan leak again and see what we can figure out there. It says that the other operator has two charges of a temporary heal, 40, probably 40 hit points, and also recoil reduction and a speed buff. That seems to fit in perfectly with what we were just reading, how this operator has self-dissolving nanobots and all allies can benefit from it. So this sounds like it might be some kind of like a nanobot-based injection that will then create a temporary buff for any affected allies. The description does say temporary health, so this might be something kind of like Doc's temporary overcharge ability, where he heals you beyond your maximum threshold and then it just sort of comes down over time back down to the normal. And then it sounds like it might also kind of give you a bit of an adrenaline boost, making your recoil reduction a little bit less harsh and also providing you with some kind of a speed buff. Now, if that is for the attacking operator and you wind up injecting somebody like Ash with that, God help us all. So there you go, that's the information that we have available to us at this time, and you pair that along with some of the things that we've found out before with that 4chan leak, and again, that is a little bit speculative on how that matches with this current information, but remember that everything in that 4chan leak did pan out to wind up being accurate information weeks, or in some cases months, before some of that information wound up being revealed. If the information on the operator abilities turned out to not be true, that would literally be the only part of that that hadn't panned out to be accurate information. So I'm putting some credibility behind this. All the other revelations within this leak did turn out to be accurate so far. So what do you guys think about how these new operators sound? Do you like the way they look? Do these sound like interesting abilities? How do you think they're going to complement the existing gameplay so far? Let me know down in the comments below, or share with me over at IcyCat25 on either Facebook or Twitter. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.